Good morning, students. Today we will move towards next property, commutativity. Okay, this commutative property for whole numbers. First we learn, then we learn for the integers and then for the rational numbers. Okay, now what is commutative property? See, in commutative property, first operation addition. First operation addition, addition. Suppose a plus b is equal to b plus a. This what it shows, this property it shows, even if you will change the order, the answer remains same. See now, 4 plus 6, suppose if I will take 4 plus 6, now what if this property it shows is equal to 6 plus 4. See, these are the two whole numbers, 4 plus 6 whole numbers. 6 plus 4, we see here, a plus b is equal to b plus a. Means both you will get the same. 4 plus 6 is equal to 10 and 6 plus 4 is equal to 10. Means even you change the order, the answer remains same. Okay. So addition. For addition, what it will come? Addition is commutative. Okay. Addition is commutative. Means it works in this property. Okay. Addition is commutative. Okay, now we will see for the subtraction. Now see, 10 minus 3. Okay, 3 minus 10. Okay, now we will get the same answer. No, see, 10 minus 3, how much we will get? These are not equal. See how they are not equal, like I have shown. 10 minus 3, 7. You will get 7. But 3 minus 10. 3 minus 10. What you will get? Minus 7. They are equal? No. They are not equal. Okay. So, subtraction is not commutative. This does not work in the subtraction. Okay. Commutative property for whole numbers, it does not work in the subtraction. Okay. So, what we will write here? Subtraction is not commutative. Subtraction is not commutative. Means A minus B is not equal to B minus A. Means A minus B is not equal to B minus A. A means 10, B means 3. Okay. So A minus B, we did here 10 minus 3. What we got? 7. But see, B minus A, if we will do, we are getting the same answer? No. So subtraction is not commutative. Okay. So this property does not work for the subtraction. See, it works in the addition. See, A plus B is equal to B plus A. When we change the order, we get the answer same. So addition is commutative, but subtraction is not commutative. We'll see for the multiplication. Okay. Now multiplication, suppose 3 multiplied by 4. Okay. A into B. Okay, is equal to B into A. Now this is B, so 4 into 3. Again you are going to get the answer same. Even we change the order, we are going to get the answer same in multiplication. 3 4s are 12, 4 3s are 12. 4 3s are 12. See, both are same. Yes, both are same. So what it will come? A into B is equal to B into A means now multiplication is commutative. What it will get? Multiplication is commutative. Multiplication is commutative means it works in the multiplication. Okay, when we change the order, we get the answer same. Okay, you see here we get the answer same, that is whole number. Yes, we got the answer same. If you will see here, we are saying for the whole number. See, you got the here whole number, but here you got the integers. It is not same. Okay, so it does not work for the subtraction, but it works in the the addition and multiplication. Now let's see it work in the division or not. Okay, suppose 12 divided by 4. Okay, and here I will 12 divided by 4 means A divided by B. Now I will see B divided by A. B means what? 4. 4 divided by A means 12. We will get same or not, that we will see. Now 12 divided by 4. 4 threes are 12. See, 4 threes are 12. Okay, 4 threes are 12. Now 4 divided by 12 means 4 upon 12. 4 ones are 4, 4 threes are 12. See, they are equal. No, here you got 3. That is whole number. Here you got fraction. Whole number on 3. These are not equal. So, A divided by B is not equal to B divided by A. A divided by B is not equal to B divided by A. Means division is not commutative. This property does not work in the division. Okay. So division is not commutative. So division is not commutative.
So again, I will write this in the
Okay, now here what I mean, just I will do the change the order. B minus A. Now what is B? Minus 3. See, B minus A I have to show now. So B is minus 3 and A is 5. See, B is minus 3. This minus sign I have given here. And what is the value of A? A value is 5. Okay, see, A minus B. Subtraction, so minus. Okay, A minus B. And what is the value of B? Minus 3. And here, B minus A. What is the B? Minus 3. B minus A. So minus sign. And A is 5. Okay, now let's see the answer. First, open the bracket 5. Minus minus plus minus. Top the bracket, negative sign, inside bracket, sandwich, and so 5 minus. Sorry, 5 plus 3. Okay, now here see minus, minus, plus, minus 3, minus 5, minus, minus, plus, and for answer, negative sign, both of them have negative sign, so for answer also, negative sign, so 5 plus 3, 8, and here we got minus 8, see here we got whole number, and here we got integers, we see here, 8 we got, and here minus 8 we got, so both of them are same, no. Both of them are not same. Both of them are not equal. They are equal? No. So, subtraction is not commutative for integers. So, what we write here? Subtraction is not commutative for integers. Okay, now next we will see multiplication. It works for the multiplication or not. Now see, it works in the addition, but it does not work in the subtraction. Now we will see for multiplication. It works in the multiplication or not. So see, it works in the multiplication or not. So see, here I will take A is equal to 3, B is equal to minus 4. A multiplied by B. And here what will come? B multiplied by A. B becomes minus 4. Minus 4 into 3. Means C. Now we will see both of them are same or not. 3, 4 are 12. This is positive integer. And this is negative integer. Okay. One number is positive, another is negative. So their product will be the negative. Here also, this is negative integer, this is positive integer. So their product will be the negative. 4 threes are 12. Okay, so both of them are same. See, this minus 12, this is also minus 12. So what we got? A multiplied by B is equal to B multiplied by A. Okay, so both of them are equal. What we got in this? A multiplied by B is equal to B multiplied by A. Why? Because see, both of them are same. Again, we got the integer and they are same. So what we will write here? Multiplication is commutative for integers. Multiplication is commutative for integers. This it work in the multiplication. This property to work in the multiplication for integers. Now we will see for the division. Again I will take one example. Now see, suppose 30 minus 30. Okay, minus 30 divided by minus 6. Now what we are doing in commutative property? We just change the order for. See, minus 30 divided by minus 6, A divided by B. Now what will come here? B divided by A. Now what is B? Minus 6 divided by, and what is A? Minus 30. Okay. So now, see here, minus 30 divided by minus 6. See here, I will show. Minus 30 divided by minus 6. Okay. See, both of them have negative sign, so their answer will be the positive. See, when we divide two negative integers, we divide them plus sign before the question. Okay. Now cancel this. 6 1 6 6 5 30. So what we got here? 5 1. So here we got 5. Okay. Now next. What is the next? Next it is minus 6 divided by minus 30. Minus 6 means 3 divided by a, minus 6 divided by minus 30. Divide them as a whole number. This sign will cancel. 6 1 plus 6 6 5 plus 30. What we got? 1 upon 5 equal. What we got answer here? 1 upon 5. Now both of them are equal? No. See, they are not equal. Here we got 5 and here we got 1 upon 5. So they are equal? No. So what we will write here? We will write here division is not commutative for integers. So what we will write here? Division is not commutative for integers. So division is not commutative for integers. Let's see now commutative property for rational numbers. Okay. Now addition. We'll see one example for addition of rational numbers. And it work in the addition or not. Okay. Now suppose if I have taken A is equal to 3 upon 7 A plus B. Okay. 3 upon 7 plus. Now B if I took 2 upon 7. Okay. A plus B. Now what we are doing in commutative property? Just we change the order. This side what we do? B plus A. Now what is B? 2 upon 7 is B. So 2 upon 7. A plus B is equal to B plus A. 2 upon 7. It is B. Now what is A? 3 upon 7. Now we just will see whether they are same or not. Now see, if denominators are same, then we can add its numerator. Now here denominators are same, so we can add directly. But if the example is given, denominators are not same, then you have to make it same by finding LCM. And then you have to check. Here for your understanding, I have given very easy example to understand this properties. But you have to take your one example by taking the denominators different and whether it can work in these or not. That you have to check. Okay. Now denominators are same. 3 plus 2, 5. 5 upon 7 you got. Okay. Now here also you see 2 plus 3, 5. 5 upon 7 you got. Okay, means both the sides you got same. Okay, see both of them are same. A plus B is equal to B plus A. See you got 5 upon 7, 5 upon 7. Means these are equal. A plus B is equal to B plus A. Means it work in the rational number. Okay, so addition is. So what we will write here? Addition is commutative. For rational numbers. Means it work in the rational numbers. Now we will take one example for the subtractions. Okay. Now suppose one example I will take, that is 5 upon 9. A minus B. We are showing subtraction. Means minus A minus B. Now 2 upon 9 if I will take. Okay. This is A. This is B. A minus B. Now what will you do here? B minus A. Means what is B now? 2 upon 9. B minus A. What is A? A is 5 upon 9. Now we will see whether they are same or not. Now if you will observe here. 5 upon 9 minus 2 upon 9. Denominators are same. Now subtract its numerator. 5 minus 2, 3. So what we got? 3 upon 9 we got. You can do the lowest step also for this. Now see here. 2 minus 5. Here see 2 minus 5. This is positive. This is negative. See now. 5 minus 2 what equal? upon 9 minus 5 upon, see now here, 2 upon 9 minus 5 upon 9. Now, denominators are same, so subtract its numerator. What you will get here? 2 minus 5. Means this is plus and this is minus. Minus, plus minus, minus. So what you will get? Minus 3 upon 9. So what you got answer here? Minus 3 upon 9. So what you got answer here? Minus 3 upon 9. You got the answer minus 3 upon 9. Here you got 3 upon 9. And here you got minus 3 upon 9. So both of them are same? No. They are not same. You got both of them are equal? No. See, what you got here? 3 upon 9 you got. And here you got minus 3 upon 9. Okay. Both of them are rational numbers, but they are not same. We didn't get it same. So what you will write here? Subtraction is not commutative for rational numbers. This is okay. So subtraction is not commutative for rational numbers. Okay, means it does not work in the subtraction. Now we'll see for the multiplication. See for the multiplication. Okay, minus 7 upon 3 multiplied by 6 upon 5. Okay. Now, minus 7 upon 3 is A and 6 upon 5 is B. So, here what we will do? B multiplied by A. A multiplied by B and here B multiplied by A. Whether they are equal or not, that we will see. Okay, 6 upon 5. B multiplied by A. Multiplied by A is minus 7 upon 3. Okay, now if you will multiply both of them, 7, 6 are 42. 3 5s are 15. Okay, here minus sign. You can do the lowest term for the terms. So see, you can do directly 3 1 the 3, 3 2 the 6. You can do for this lowest term. Okay, now 6 7s are 42. That is minus, because see here this is positive, this is negative. So the product will be the negative. 5 3s are 15. Again you got the same. Again you got the same. See, minus 45. 42, see minus 42 upon 15, minus 42 upon 15. Still we can do the lowest term for this. Means both of them are same. Even if we do the lowest term for this, we are going to get the same here for these also same. Okay, means both of them are same. Means both are equal. A multiplied by B is equal to B multiplied by A in rational numbers. Okay, for multiplication. So multiplication is commutative for rational numbers. So what we write here? Multiplication is commutative for rational numbers. Okay, so multiplication is commutative for rational numbers. Both of them are same. Let's see it working for the division or not. Okay, now here I will take one example. A I will take minus 5 upon 4. Okay, and minus 5 upon 4 divided by B I will take 3 upon 7. A divided by B. A is minus 5 upon 4 and B is 3 upon 7. Okay, so and here I will take B divided by A. What is B? 3 upon 7 is B divided by A. A is minus 5 upon 4. Okay. So now what we will do? Solve first this side. Minus 5 upon 4. Multiply. Now what we will do? We do the reciprocal of this number 7 upon 3. Integrate. Now calculate this. 5 7s are 35 and 4 3s are 12. And see here, this number is negative and this number is positive. So their product will be the negative. So minus 35 upon 12 we got. Now here we do the same. 3 upon 7 multiplied by See what you will get. Reciprocal of this number, so 4 upon minus 5 you will get. Okay. So 3 4s are 12, 7 5s are 35, and this one number is negative, another number is C. Negative, positive. So product will be the negative, or you can give in middle also. So here you got 30 minus 35 upon 12. Here you got minus 12 upon 35. So they are saying no, they are not equal. See, minus 35 upon 12, and here we got 12 upon minus 12 upon 35. So what you will write here, division is not commutative for rational numbers. Why? Because they are not semi-dictator set. So division is not commutative for rational numbers.